Next up, we have Lucrecia Krause, who will be presenting Business Architecture Using Power BI. Lucrecia is an experienced technology professional. She started her career in programming, then moved into project management, program management, business analysis, business architecture, and improvement initiatives with Hewlett-Packard. Lucrecia studied computer science, has an MBA and postgraduate in strategic quality management. She's very passionate about process design, improvements, and data for decision making. Can't wait to hear from you, Lucrecia.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for having me here at the Power BI Woman Summit. I'm going to be talking about business architecture and how we can implement it using Power BI. My name is Lucrecia Krause. I manage a group of business analysts at the University of Central Florida. I'm going to start defining what is business architecture. Business architecture is a discipline that represents a holistic, multidimensional business view of capabilities, the end-to-end delivery, information and organizational structure, and how this relationship about among business views and strategies, products, policies, initiatives, and stakeholders. Business architecture, the source is Wikipedia. What business architecture helps organization is to answer different business questions. How the organization implements strategies, and then the business architecture is going to help us identify who is implementing the strategy, where, why, what, how, the how well we are doing the in the business, when, and the whys. What I'm going to be presenting is three business architecture activities that we can implement using Power BI. But we can get very creative. It's a lot of visuals, and it's not only three. We can implement a lot of the business architecture using Power BI. So the first one that I'm going to be covering is the who. When we are trying to answer the who is in the business, is who is doing the work, question, the best place to start is with the organizational chart. These are the charts that we see that are embedded into Office 365. In other organizations, they use visual or other visuals. The nice thing that if we do it in Power BI is that we can apply the visuals as we are building other layers of the organization. The first one that we are going to be exploring is the when trying to answer the who is doing the work question, the best place to start is with the organizational chart. For this one, what we need is to import the data file that contains the employee information. In my case, I did it with Excel, but with all the plugins, and we can pick from any source. What is important is that we have the employee ID, the name, the job title, and something that is really important is the manager. So that way we are reflecting the hierarchy to who is the employee reporting to. So I have here a very simple example that it has the employee name, the title, the department, a manager, and the city. What you see that is important for this particular org chart, as I was saying, is the hierarchy. So we have the CIO, and then we have the department manager or director that is reporting to the CIO, and then we have other employees that are reporting to the manager. Here is the visual that I'm using is the org chart by MAQ. This is a free chart that you can import in Power BI. just search by org chart, and then you import the visual you selected, and then you are going to select the employee ID. Then you are going to assign the manager. That's the parent ID is going to be the manager, and then you can have by job level or by city, or you can have different sub levels or groups, and this is how it's going to look like. And then we can also add filters, and we can slice the information in different views. The second one is the how. When we are trying to answer the how question, how the work is performed, the process view in Power BI work really, really well. A process mining in Power BI let us view the organizational details on how the work is done. The nice thing with the process mining is that usually we have a process that is in like visual, but we don't know if all the steps are being followed. With the process mining, the nice thing is that we can bring a log file, and then we see the exact steps and everything that is happening. Organizations have their process in, let's say, visual. With visual, you have how the process is designed to be. But the nice thing, if we analyze the data with actual logs using the process mining, is going to let us see the exact flow of how everything is being done. And I'm going to show you. So in this one, I import the PAFNOW process mining visual. Is also free. For this one, we will need log file with activity, the who is performing the activity, and at a minimum, a start and end time stamp. And then we select the PAFNOW process mining visual. From here, we are going to have a case ID, then we have an event, and then we are going to, in this case, I'm ordering by month. And this is how the process map is drawn for us. And this is not a process of how we are designing it, but this is the actual, how the process is really happening. And if you see in this one, we are seeing that the process for some cases are starting at the very beginning, but then we have others that are starting in a different phase. So they are jumping the initial activities, and then we have a couple of variants. It is a very nice view because we can identify why is that we are having these variants, how we can improve it, or if it's something that is acceptable, but it's really handy to be able to see the process as is, so we can compare if it's really performing the way that we were intending to have the process. And then the last one that I'm going to be showing is the where. When we are trying to answer the where question, Power BI has many map visualization options that can help us the where our customers, employees, vendors, or suppliers are located. This extra layer of adding the location, Power BI is really powerful. For this particular visual, we need a file that, in this case, I'm doing employee location, but as I was saying, it can be anything that we want to map. It can be customers, vendors, employees. So in this particular case, I have a log that it contains the employee location, city, and the city and county, but you can have a city and country. You can the only thing that I advise is for the cities, we need to make sure that if it's duplicate cities, we need to make sure that we clean the data, because if it's the same city in one country and in another country, it can map the wrong city. So we just need to be careful how we are cleaning the data. The visualization that I selected is the one that is called the field map, is the one that looks like this. This one is a standard visualization in Power BI. So here I have employee ID, the job level, the start date, and the employee location. And then from here, map the fields in location, employee location, and then this is how it looks. Thank you, everyone. It was a pleasure to be here. Thank you very much for the opportunity. So just to recap, we review three visuals that we can use to implement the business architecture. The first one is the organizational chart. For this one, we use the organizational chart by MAQ software. Then the next one, it was the process visual, and this one is the PAFNOW process mining. And then the last one, it was the visual for the maps, the field map. And this one is a visual that is already part of Power BI. Thank you very much. If you have questions, please feel free to reach out. My LinkedIn is Lucrecia, last name Krause, Lucrecia Krause. Thank you very much and have a great day.
Thank you for your session on business architecture in Power BI, Lucrecia.